Some people tap their feet, some people snap their fingers, and some people just sway back and forth. I just sort of do them all together, I guess.
And now here is Elvis Presley.
I got news for you, baby.
So excited, I could just, can't wait.
I think Presley was a star.
Well, the news.
Oh, he's such a sexy person. He will always be the king, no matter what.
Hello, viewers. I will start this video in a second with a extended and partially deepfake trailer of the upcoming Elvis movie. Furthermore, you'll see the current exhibition at Graceland. We'll have short news flashes, we'll have new books, and a top 10 of Elvis songs compiled by the fans. My name is Maier, and you are watching the Elvis Presley News Report of June 2022. Okay guys, now let that film reel run!
There are some who'd make me out to be the villain of this here story.
Let's don't let a good thing die.
Are you born with destiny? Or does it just come knocking at your door?
He's a young singer from Memphis, Tennessee. Give him a warm hayride welcome. Mr. Elvis Presley.
Get a haircut, buttercup.
In that moment, I watched that skinny boy transform into a superhero.
Well, you may go to college. You may go to school. Have a pink Cadillac, but don't you make nobody's fool now, baby. Come back, baby, I wanna play house. So you always play house.
What all that? The wiggle.
The what?
Them girls won't see you wiggle. Move, man.
What are you thinking, Jimmy?
I don't know what I'm thinking.
Please, Lord, don't let him hurt my baby.
Hurt him? Looks like they want to.
Now, I don't know nothing about music, but I could see in that girl's eyes, he was a taste of forbidden fruit. She could have eaten him alive. He was my destiny.
I wish to promote you, Mr. Presley.
One through a party in a town of jail.
Are you ready to fly?
I'm ready. Ready to fly.
Tomorrow, all of America will be talking about Elvis Presley.
Or is it not enough to move around so much during the take?
I can't move, I can't sing.
Some people want to put me in jail as well as moving.
They might put me in jail for walking across the street, but you're a famous white boy.
The way you sing is God-given, so there can't be nothing wrong with it.
Martin Luther King has been shot to death in Memphis.
That's all right for you.
Tragedy, but it has nothing to do with us.
It has everything to do with us.
Reverend once told me, when things are too dangerous to say, sing.
Sing!
I'm gonna be 40 soon, and nobody's gonna remember me.
I need to get back to who I really am.
And who are you, Oz?
Making the most of this thing while I can. This could all be over in a flash.
the same, you and I. We are two odd, lonely children reaching for eternity. The greatest show on earth.
Elvis has left the building.
This clip was made with the very, very kind cooperation of the deepfake wizard from Brazil, Mr. Luigi Lupo.
Elvis, you're doing your own singing?
I am.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how do you even prepare to do that?
Hours of hard work.
Check out his fantastic YouTube channel. Lisa Marie and Priscilla Presley have already seen the film and they have both expressed their praises extensively on their social media outlets. Let me pick one sentence from what they wrote. Lisa Marie says, for instance, "Thank you, Baz Luhrmann, for setting the record straight in such a deeply profound and artistic way." And Priscilla wrote, "It is a true story told brilliantly and creatively that only Baz, in his unique artistic way, could have delivered." The movie had its premiere at the Cannes Film Festival on Wednesday, May 25, 2022. It runs for a staggering 2 hours and 39 minutes and promotion for the movie is starting to get going, as the first movie posters have surfaced on the streets. The American actors Tom Hanks and Austin Butler will fly to Australia to attend the Australian premiere at the State Theatre in Sydney on June 5th. More names regarding the movie's soundtrack have been announced. These are Australia's Tame Impala, American singer-songwriter Jasmine Sullivan, dance music veteran Diplo with Sway Lee, Chris Isaac, and Stevie Nicks. At this moment, I know that country singer Kacey Musgraves took care of the song Can't Help Falling in Love. And 2021 Eurovision Song Contest winners Maneskin from Italy sings If I Can Dream.
Mr. President, try not to move around so much during the takes.
I can't move, I can't sing.
In short, the highest paid Elvis item at the Gotta Have Rock and Roll auction of April 30th was this guitar that Elvis used in the movie Frankie and Johnny. It was sold for $24,000. Though not exactly Elvis memorabilia in the true sense of the word, but still nice mentioning is the sale of a so-called Elvis canvas by Andy Warhol. The estimation was between $15 to $25 million and it was sold bang in the middle for $20,581,000 on May 19. This price includes the buyer's premium for auction house Sotheby's. Último Trem para Memphis is the Portuguese edition of Peter Guralnik's Last Train to Memphis. It was released as a 640 pages book in Brazil on May 2nd. Everybody seems to jump on the bandwagon while Elvis is hot in the media because of the upcoming movie. Warner Brothers, for instance, will reissue for the third time Viva Las Vegas on Blu-ray on June 20th. Also included in this set is the movie on DVD and the soundtrack on CD. The first Viva Las Vegas Blu-ray was released in 2007 and the second edition was released in 2014 to celebrate the movie's 50th anniversary. Also, Alana Nash will reissue her book The Extraordinary Story of Colonel Tom Parker on July 13. In the French Pop Icons book series, a 300 pages book on Elvis Presley will come available on June 3rd. It features 80 illustrations made by 22 illustrators. Here is the promo clip. British superfan and author Annie Nixon died on May 10, 2022. She attended 40 live performances of Elvis in Las Vegas between 1972 and 1976. Annie Nixon was a regular contributor to the British fan club magazine Elvis Monthly and co-wrote several books about Elvis. The rigorousness of her research on Elvis says a lot about her, because she scripted the first guided tour of Memphis for the British fan club in 1972. She had researched the guided tour so thoroughly back in the day that it is still used today.
We are so excited here at Graceland to open up our latest exhibition called Dress to Rock, and it really chronicles Elvis's stage fashion. There's over 100 items on display, everything from jumpsuits to belts, capes, accessories, boots, original designer sketches, receipts.
I think it's amazing what they've done. I think this one, when we walked in, we just went, whoa, this is really well done.
Today, when you think about Elvis, you've got your 70s Elvis, which is definitely the Vegas jumpsuit Elvis. And that was all due to Bill Ballou and Elvis's envision of what a stage performer should be. I mean, we know Elvis was a trendsetter from the beginning. He changed fashion from the 50s all the way through. And this is just a way of looking at how he changed basically rock style and what it meant to be a rock star.
To see all the suits, and this is just beautiful.
Some call it the Memphis suit. The designer actually called it the kitchen sink suit because he used every stud and stone he had to create this outfit. The unique thing is that in March of 74, Elvis was wearing this jumpsuit when he recorded the live album at Mid-South Coliseum. And the song, How Great Thou Art, won him his last Grammy. So this is the jumpsuit Elvis was wearing when he performed that song. This is the most iconic of Elvis's jumpsuits. It's the American Eagle jumpsuit he wore during his 1973 Aloha from Hawaii special. It's also one of the only ones that Elvis really had a request to make, because when he was going live worldwide, he wanted to wear something that reminded people of America. Him and the designer went through several ideas, including an outline of the U.S. map, possibly the U.S. flag, and then eventually settling on the American Eagle with the red, white, and blue color scheme. This is the must-see exhibit for any Elvis fan in your life. So if you're an Elvis fan or you know someone who's an Elvis fan, you have to bring them to Graceland.
In the Elvis Presley News Report of March, I ask for your favorite song that Elvis recorded in the 1950s. But I would love to hear your favorite Elvis song that was recorded in the 1950s. You can nominate just one song. I received 125 entries, and here is the top 10. 7 songs received each 3 votes. So number 10 consists of Trying to Get to You, That's Alright Mama, One Night, Milk Cow Blues Boogie, Love Me Tender, Love Me and Don't. Number 7 consists of 3 songs that received 4 votes each. Wear My Ring Around Your Neck, Any Way You Want Me, and A Fool Such As I. Number 5 consists of 2 songs that received 5 votes each. My Baby Left Me and Baby Let's Play House. Number 4 is Heartbreak Hotel. Number 3 is the highest Sun recording, Mystery Train. Number 2 is Jailhouse Rock. And his most popular song, as far as the viewers of my channel are concerned, is...
This is my biggest record. And
Don't Be Cruel with 12 votes.
It goes something like this.
You know I can be found. Oh no, it's him again. Hey, just wanted to tell you that this is my last video before Baz Luhrmann's Elvis movie will be released. I go with fans and friends to the cinema on June 25th, and hopefully I can include my reaction in the video that I will upload on July 1st. I would love to hear your reaction too in the comment section of the July video. My advice would be for you to sit back, relax and enjoy the movie. That's all for this month. Hope to see you next time. Until then, have a happy Elvis Presley day. You have a happy